And a shaman receives his enlightenment by going off into the forest by himself to be completely alone. A shaman is a man, in other words, who has undergone solitariness. He's gone away into the forest to find out who he really is, because it's very difficult to find that out while you're with other people. The reason is that other people are busy all the time telling you who you are. But if you want to find out who you are before your father and mother conceived you, who you really are, you almost have to go off by yourself. Go into the forest and stop talking, even stop thinking words, and be absolutely alone. Listen to the great silences. And then, if you're lucky, you recover from the illusion that you're just little me, the so-and-so, and you attain the state of nirvana, which means the relieved state, the sigh of relief. I've at last discovered that I don't have to survive. I can survive, of course, but I don't really have to. Because you discover, you see, that what you really are doesn't have to survive. Because it's what there is. The real you is it, or that. Tat tvam asi, that art thou, as the Hindus say. That is to say, when a man or woman has fulfilled his or her life in the world of society, it's the normal thing to do for a person to quit their status in society and become what's called a forest dweller, or become a shramana and go outside the stockade and become a nobody. They give up their name, that is to say, the label which designates who they are in terms of caste or class. They become unclassified people. A shramana has no label. He is an unlabeled body. Receives his enlightenment by going off into the forest by himself, to be completely alone. The shaman is a man, in other words, who has undergone solitariness. He's gone away into the forest to find out who he really is, because it's very difficult to find that out while you're with other people. The reason is that other people are busy all the time telling you who you are. But if you want to find out who you are before your father and mother conceived you, who you really are, you almost have to go off by yourself. Go into the forest and stop talking, even stop thinking words, and be absolutely alone. Listen to the great silences. And then, if you're lucky, you recover from the illusion that you're just little me with so-and-so, and you attain the state of nirvana, which means the relieved state, the sigh of relief. I've at last discovered that I don't have to survive. I can't survive, but I don't really have to. Because you discover, you see, that what you really are doesn't have to survive. Because it's what there is. The real you is it, or that, tat tvamasi, that not thou, as the Hindus say. That is to say, when a man or woman has fulfilled his or her life in the world of society, it's the normal thing to do for a person to quit their status in society and become what's called a forest dweller, or become a shramana and go outside the stockade and become a nobody. They give up their name, that is to say, the label which designates who they are in terms of caste or class. They become unclassified.